Good afternoon. Welcome to the press center of the Ministry of Defense of Ukraine. Here is the weekly update of the situation in the operations area of the joint forces from 18th to 24th May 2020. Over the last week, the number of the ceasefire violation has significantly increased in comparison with the previous week. Disregarding the Minsk agreements, the enemy continued to shell the JFO positions with 122mm artillery systems, as well as 120 and 82mm mortars, which should be withdrawn from the front line. The enemy also used grenade launchers, heavy machine guns, and other small arms. Moreover, on May 22nd, occupation troops used UAVs to drop VOK 17 grenades over the position of Ukrainian defenders near Bogdanivka and Starohnativka settlements. In general, from 18th to 24th May, Ukrainian defenders' position fell under provocative fire by the Russian occupation troops for 81 times. On a daily basis, the enemy shelled Ukrainian positions with forbidden heavy armament. Over the course of the previous week, the enemy used 82 and 120mm mortars to shell positions of Ukrainian defenders near Novotoshkivske, Orikhove, Krymske, Shume, Novoalexandrivka, Pivdenne, Trukhizbenka, Mayorsk, Size, and Novoluhanske settlements on Luhansk directions, as well as Bogdanivka, Avdiivka, Hnutove, Krasnohorivka, and Vodyane settlements on Donetsk direction. Also, during 23rd and 24th May, in a flagrant violation of the Minsk agreements and international humanitarian law, the enemy shelled Kamyanka and Novoluhanske settlements with 122mm artillery systems. The Russian occupation troops fired more than 65 artillery projectiles against our positions. What is more, artillery firing positions were placed in a close proximity to the residential areas in the temporarily occupied Bayrak, Vasilivka, and Yakovlivka settlements. Apart from that, as a result of the shelling of Kamyanka settlement, two civilian houses were heavily damaged. Fortunately, there were no casualties among civilian population. Our brave warriors opened adequate fire in response to suppress enemy's activity and strictly adhering to the Minsk agreements. According to the intelligence data, approximately 10 Russian mercenaries were destroyed and 19 were injured as a result of the resolute actions of the units deployed to the JFO area. Unfortunately, during the last week, one Ukrainian serviceman was killed in action, 6 were wounded in action, and 5 got combat trauma. Minister of Defense of Ukraine expresses sincerest condolences to families and loved ones of the deceased defender. And now to the information of the Defense Intelligence Directorate of the Minister of Defense of Ukraine. Russian Federation continues to supply the Russian occupation troops with armament and ammunition through the uncontrolled border areas. 2 weeks ago, Russian Federation provided its occupation troops with 3 wagons of ammunition, more than 10 tanks, 8 combat vehicles, and up to 30 military trucks full of small arms and grenade launchers munitions. I would like to also stress that as of May 25th, no COVID-19 infection case among the personnel of the joint forces was recorded. This is all information for now. Glory to Ukraine.